Huh? No. Okay, so that doesn't seem to be working. What's up, people? I'm Zogue, and welcome to my world. We're here, we're doing things, back on FTB Sky Factory 3, and there have been a few changes that I would like to point out to you. And that is that I've made a few more chickens. Now, I have kind of restructured this a little bit. If you don't remember, there was some bloodwood here and some kind of a weird thing. That was always going to be torn down. I didn't really like it. I just never got around to tearing it down and reorganizing. But now we have lava chickens and water chickens here. And this is a very cool thing. I'm liking this. I'll show you what they drop here in a second. But we also have the enderpearl chicken and the netherwort chicken, which are both going down here now. So we have enderpearls, plenty of them. And we have the netherwort. Now, I don't know if any of these guys are actually still have one enderpearl in here right now that I can take out. I need kind of to remove this guy because now we have an enderpearl chicken and I would rather stuff be stored over here rather than over there. And we're going to clear that out. But anyway, you kind of get the gist of that. I'm going to end up doing that off camera more than likely. Yeah, we're going to mess with a magic bean here in a little bit. But, yeah. Now, these guys are really cool because what they drop are lava eggs and water eggs, which basically are throwable buckets. And it's a very, very, very cool thing. I'm going to put the lava over here so it doesn't burn down my wooden structures. Almost everything I do is out of wood, so that would be pretty bad. But if I throw this... Oh! Oh, they're not throwable buckets. I thought you could throw them. I guess you have to place them. Oh, wait. You know what? Let me get some... Yeah. Yeah, see, it's just... I thought you could throw the egg. I thought it was a throwable source. It's not. You can't throw these guys. They're just basically buckets, which is still kind of interesting. It's still pretty neat, actually. I'm going to get a little bit of lag lag spikes here just because of that stuff. That's a lot of water updates right there going on every tick until it goes all the way to the bottom. It'll be fine. Anyway, I thought you could throw them. Anyway, all right. Well, that's a bummer, but whatever. Also, Matt L. told me about the magic bean. And that this guy right here is kind of interesting. Now I have two. So this one, I was trying to look up information on it. It's a random things magic bean. Okay, now from what I'm told, it's a near instant growing one, but I got some bone meal anyway. We're going to play with it just in case. And it's supposed to grow up to build height. Now, like I said, I have two of these, right? The first one, I want to see if it sticks around, if you can break it, if... You know, you can harvest it in any way. I want to play with it just to see. And if it looks cool, if it's an interesting thing, and I tell you what we're going to do, actually. I'm going to increase the size of this. I'm actually going to do even one bigger because I don't know how big this thing's going to be. Oh, of course. I don't have enough. I'm missing one dirt, actually. How bummer is that? I don't know if I have... Actually, I'll tell you what I can do. I can right-click these now. I didn't show you the guys that. I can actually right-click these crops now, which is really awesome. I love that. I don't have to pick them up and replant them or anything. I can just kind of bloop, 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 bloop. But anyway, so, yeah, 23 of them. I did get more of those seeds is another thing that changed. So if I go get more dirt, can you do what I want you to do? Thank you. All right, so now I have plenty of dirt. Well, not plenty. I'm still working on that. I need a lot more dirt for that. I want this to be daylight. So we're going to go and make it day. We're going to play with this seed. But yeah, so this thing, I want to see if there is a way to harvest it. I'm going to try everything. Maybe even going all the way to the silk touch shears method. But I don't know exactly how to get silk touch quick like and in a hurry. Because there aren't tinker's tools. I guess I could try, well, yeah, that wouldn't be shears with silk touch. Anyway, there's no Tinker Tools shears, so I can't, you know, just put the silky jewel or anything on it. I can't really do that. It has to be an actual silk touch, and I'm not really set up for regular old enchantments. So, not sure how that's going to happen. We might have to leave it around for a little while. But, this guy is supposed to grow... Oh, that was so cool. Oh my goodness. I want you to be bigger. That was awesome. Now, I'm told that you actually climbed this really, really fast. Watch this. Ready? I'm tapping forward. So now if I hold it down, meow! So fast. It's ridiculous. And when you get to the top, it's apparently really easy to fall off. Oh, build height. Oh, there's a thing here. But now, since I can fly, we're good. So now we have the bean pod, apparently. Wow. Oh, yeah. By the way, check these out. These were the clouds from when we did Sky Factory 2.5 and converted it over. The clouds turned into metamorphic taiga stone slabs, which is an interesting thing. But anyway, yeah, so now we have the bean pod from Random Things here. Apparently, it used to spawn a platform with a chest in it, but now it's just a bean pod. So we're going to go ahead. I'm going to place some of this stuff around the outside of it. So hopefully we get everything. We don't want anything. I guess I do have my magnet on, so we should be good in reality. But just in case, we're going to go ahead and build this guy out a little bit. Just in case. We're going to see what we get out of this. Because it's supposed to give you a bunch of goodies, right? Beak. Ooh, I got some stuff. What did I get? I got some regular beans. Okay. I'm not sure what the regular beans do. Behold, 18 iron. I didn't have any of this on me, did I? I don't think I did. 4 gold and 3 diamonds? I don't think I did. I'm not sure. But you get the regular beans, too. What are the regular beans used for? Lesser magic bean. Bean stew. So it's like a food source. Got it. Okay, what else? If there's anything else. It's just a bean from Random Things. Make some stock from it. So, a lesser magic bean. What can we use here? Experience imbue. What is that about? You don't tell me what you do, but it looks kind of interesting. Imbuing station. It doesn't tell me what you do. Experience brew. I can't, like, look it up. I can look it up online or whatever, but now... Oh! Whoa! Oh, they're insta-break. Holy crap, even going down. That's crazy. Okay, let me go ahead and just kind of get all of my dirt back here. Dirt is actually pretty valuable in this. So, yeah. Now. Nothing. Okay, so chances are you're not going to be able to do anything. I'm thinking shears aren't even going to work. But we're going to give it a shot. And then I want to try something else. Again, remember, I have two magic... Well, now I have one. I have one more magic bean. So I want to test this out with some shears. So we can play with the second one. Magic bean. And that's not what I want, actually. Shears is what I want. So there's one other thing that I kind of want to test. Now that I know that they can be broken down, I want to try something else. Wait, can I just fly against it? I can't. There we go. Whoosh. It's really, really interesting that this is a thing. Holy crapo. Oh, wow. It actually slows you down right at the top. That's pretty neat. That's pretty nifty. But shears do not work. So I tell you what we're going to do. Whoa. These things are certainly insta-break. Look at that. That is just crazy, man. That's so nuts. But by the way, this actually looks really cool from up here. You know? Anyway, keep going. So now what I want to do is actually answer a question that Matt L. didn't know. And we're going to see what happens if we put it right in the middle of this guy. Now, it's a thin beanstalk. I was hoping it was going to be a lot thicker, but it's not. It's just not. So it's not going to look all that well placed in here. It's going to look a little weird, but we're going to try it anyway. We'll see what happens with this situation. So let's go get our other magic bean. Magique. There we go. Just like so. And we're going to go right in the center here, just in case it does look kind of cool. This should be the center. Yes. Center. So center and center. This one. Boom. What happens? Oh, it pokes a hole through it. Oh, that's cool. That's pretty neat, but I bet I can't climb through it though. Nope, can't. I sure can't, but it does go through the platforms. Why is that not the center of the platform? That's the center of this platform. but it does not appear. Oh, it is. It is actually the center. It's only because we can see the outline on this side, but we can't see the outline over here. But it is actually, the outline's right there. So it is the center of this platform. It just looked like this might have been the outer edge of it. Yeah, anyway, it's weird. It's kind of weird about that. But no, that's pretty cool though. It's pretty cool. Let's go get our goodies from up top. So we can't. Yeah, what I was thinking is that maybe we could have a magic bean breaking area so that if it generated the pod underneath whatever ceiling, then we could have like a magic bean situation where we just have the magic bean planted so it grows like one or two blocks, but we could literally be on the ground while we break the pod and then we would be good. But it does not appear that that is a thing. So yeah, it appears that it's just going to go through build height. More diamonds, more gold, more iron, and two emeralds, and more beans, for whatever that's worth. But anyway, let me go ahead and just break this guy all the way down to the ground. Probably replace that topiary dress. Kinda got a little messed up. And, yeah. I don't think we're gonna keep one of these in the middle, because I think if it was the thicker version, a thicker version of it, maybe a 2x2 or a 3x3 even, I think it would be really, really cool if it was in the middle of it. But unless we make one ourselves, I don't think we can actually get that. Although it does bring to mind another design idea that I have. Again, like I said, this floating ceiling is not going to be the extent of this design right here. There's going to be more to it, but I want to finish the top part before we go into any more plans about what's going to continue, what's going to be there. It's going to look pretty cool, though. In any case, I think it's time we move on with this episode and actually start doing something else. Oh. Thanks. Okay, all right. I'm getting excited about this one. This is really, really cool. This is a new mod I've never messed with before. Not this guy. I'm checking him out, actually. We still got a lot. 29 blocks of coal, but look at this. We have 140 millibuckets. 140 buckets of creosote oil in the tank. That's really, really good. But anyway, yeah, so we should be able to do a lot of the power stuff here. In the coming episode, so we can actually finally get our power situation dealt with. But what I was just, I just spent, I don't know, a long time looking up something very specific. And some of you may have messed with this mod, okay? But I never have. It's the Roots mod. Now, first and foremost, this tablet, this instruction booklet is one of the coolest I have ever seen. This is really, really, really cool. There was another one, and I don't remember what it's called. I cannot remember. But it doesn't seem like the mod made it. I don't think it was updated. But it was actually a mod back in 1.8.9 that shot out a particle. And it was like a portal kind of thing that lingered. It's on par with that one in my mind. This is a really, really cool looking booklet. Like, I really, really like this. But what this mod is kind of, I wouldn't say it's like Botania, but it's kind of like Botania without the flower magic, without the, it's like a mixture between Botania and witchery in my mind. Cause like I said, I was kind of looking through a lot of this stuff, you know, and in Botania you get mana and you kind of use that mana to do things. In witchery, you have an altar that you supercharge and that altar kind of gives you altar power to do things. So it's kind of in between because you make an altar and it doesn't have any of the mana or anything, but there are certain energies that you can use. It does have the concept of another dimension, although you can't travel there, you can't actually do anything. It has flower stuff, but it's not exactly the same as Botania. Like, it doesn't generate, it's just using regular things here. And in order to get into this guy, I kind of want to get into it a little bit, but I'm thinking here. First of all, we need bark harvesting, okay? Trees are very important to natural magic. Using some wood and saplings, you can create a knife capable of softly harvesting the bark from trees, which can be used in recipes and rituals. This is how we get bark, which is kind of, it's just an ingredient used for various things. So if we go here, first of all, we need the bark knife. Boom, we got the bark knife. I have the bark knife. The bark knife is mine, and I have started. First of all, I want to check out, because there's a couple things here. Old Root, Verdant Sprig, and Infernal Bulbs. Old Root, we only have 7 of those, which is unfortunate. Verdant, I have 4 of those, and Infernal Bulb. Infernal, I have 1 of those. So we're kind of low on those 3 resources, and all of those are very, very important to have. So we need to look into automating those. Now, old roots you get from breaking grass, regular old grass blocks, which we don't even have, but I could like bone meal and chop them down or whatever, and I can get old roots that way. Of course, we want to automate it, but you get the idea. That's where they come from. The verdant sprigs come from fully grown crops. It doesn't matter what crops. Apparently, I don't know if these guys work or not. By the way, let me... Okay. Do 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 do. Bing 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 bing. Okay. I don't know if those crops work, but we do have other crops. Like these guys will give them to you, and certain other things. So we can set up an automated farm to get those. Which I keep going over here to get into my system, but that's not what it. Oh crap. Okay. I was soaking up some stuff that I didn't want to soak up. But yeah. I lost my train of thought. So we can automate both of those. And Infernal Bulbs are from Nether Wart, which I think we can do. Like, you get them from harvesting Nether Wart, and it's like a 1 in 10 chance for the Nether Wart or something to drop them. It's a 1 in 20 chance for the crops, and it's like a 1 in 30 chance for the grass. So it can take a while. We need to automate those, but I kind of want to jump into this before we start automating all that stuff. Because this mod is so cool. I want to go as far as I can with it. And it's just unfortunate that I can't. Not yet. Like, I can get into it a little bit, but not a huge amount. Now, here's the thing. There are rare plants and herbs that are crucial for many aspects of natural magic. Old roots, a 1 in 40 chance when breaking tall grass. They are needed for a lot of early magic, as they are required for spells without modifiers. Tall grass? It has to be tall grass? They can also be eaten to restore a very small amount of hunger. These, 1 in 30 chance when harvesting fully grown crops of all kinds. It says all kinds, but again, I don't know if the crops from whatever mod that is, the resource crops stuff, if they count or not. I really don't know. And then you have the Infernal Bulbs, 1 in 20 chance from grown netherwort. This is actually probably going to be the easiest one to get. But as soon as we get that. Growth powder is really cool. This guy simply can grow grass on dirt. So this is like the grass seeds that we get from sifting things. And it just plants one little itty bitty thing of grass. This one, you throw it within 4 blocks and it does an area effect and it grows grass on dirt. Which is actually really, really, really cool. We just don't really need it. And then you have the stew, which we don't need. And then you have the healing poultice, which we don't need. So this is the first step. The second step is spellcraft, where you just create spells. You can do various things, and we're going to play with all of them, but I just don't have the materials to do any of this. We can get some of the other stuff. Like the mortar, I can make the mortar. Can I make the pestle? I might. I don't know if I have enough diorite for that. So let's... First of all, we're going to try to do the mortar, which is in here somewhere. You. Come here, you. Okay, good. I have that. The pestle is right here. Good. Oh, how do we make diorite? Oh, I can do that. No problem at all, actually. That's just some quartz. We all know that I have plenty of quartz to go around. Now, we have both of these guys, and you don't combine them together or anything. It's not a single item that you use in your inventory. I think you place them. Or maybe this is something you use in your hand, but then you place this. So again, we're going to use the middle of this area. Yeah, there's that. And then I guess I'm guessing I can push P and lay you on the ground, which is really cool. We're going to have that right beside the guy. And that way, anytime I need to use it, I can just use it. It's really cool. That's not what I wanted to do. Thank you. Nope. Thank you. All right. Don't right click this time. Now with this guy, what else do we need for this setup? Okay, next. We have that. Imbuing a staff. Okay, your mortar and pestle yield a fine petal dust for use in spells, but it can't really be used on its own. With this device, you can channel natural energies from that powder. Okay, so I need to actually go back one because I don't know exactly how to use it. The flora in the world around you seem to have vast untapped power. What better way to process access that than mashing them into a pulp? Okay, of course, mashing... The special fashioned out of smooth white stone should do the task nicely. Using the mortar and pestle is quite simple. Detailed in this tablet are many recipes for different spells. You will need all of these ingredients, as well as a particular base ingredient. To create the most basic possible spell, simply place in the spell's recipe, as well as an old root. This will allow for a spell with no modifiers. Okay, so... Really, if the Inferno Bulbs are the best thing, which they are, as far as I know, they are the best thing to use, then we... I'm not sure if we need Old Root in the recipe, other than, like, the default, you know, to get no modifiers. We're going to play with it, though. We're going to see if we can create a spell today. And I'm not sure which one. So how do I... Okay, so I guess... So I make the Imbuer... Can't really be used on its own. With this device, you channel natural energies from that powder into a branch of wood. Simply place in a stick, place in your powder, and wait for your staff to pop out. So this is the Imbuer. So we put in a stick, place in your powder. So I guess it doesn't tell me anything about the flowers, but I guess you just put them in here and then mash them? It sounds like that's all that there is to it. It's getting dark, but there's the nighttime symbol. I was looking in the top left, in case you weren't aware. I was looking here, waiting for it to switch over to say nighttime, because that's when I'm actually able to sleep. But let's see about some of the flowers. Like, do we have flowers? I don't even think we have any. So I'm going to have to get some bone meal. I want to see something, actually. Like, for example, you. Can I make you? Like, okay, I can do mana infusion to change over what you are, because we do actually have Botania in here as well, but not what I needed. All right, let me go get some bone meal so we can actually see about getting some flowers. And again, this is one of those things we're definitely going to automate in the future, because this mod is really, really cool. I want to play with it. Yeah, give me some flowers, man. I think I should have a bunch of these. It's just the word flower just isn't in it. So I probably have a bunch of these already. Like dandelion doesn't have the word flower. Rose or poppy doesn't have the word flower, you know? So it's kind of like that. So if I go like this, let's put in a poppy, and then we take this. Oh, no, I right-clicked. Okay, so that's not how you do it. Place you in. Okay, so that's not it. How do we do it? Do I have to do more than one? Okay, there's a bunch. Everything. I have corn kernels. Corn crop mod. I didn't know that was a mod. Okay, that's a weird thing. We're going to take a look at that in the future. How do I use it? It doesn't say how to actually get... Oh, do I have to wait? Is this a wait thing? Or do I have to do something particular? Let's see... Let's wait for now, but we're going to read this to see if it actually says anything. Harvesting rare materials. We already read this, right? We went, oh, dragon's eyes. Ooh, quartz flowers. I need to get to the end for that, though. Okay, I already know about that one. Rudy Stoot, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so that's not what I need. I need the next one. The mortar. It doesn't say anything about how to do it. Seem to have vast untapped power processing them or mashing them into a pulp. Course, to mash, you're going to need something to mash with. Should do the task nicely. Detailed in this tablet are many recipes for different spells. You will need all of these ingredients as well as a particular base ingredient to create the most basic. Okay, so simply place in the spell's recipe as well as an old root. Oh, okay, so let's try. There's Terra. So, okay, what spell do we want to create? Because I think this is where we got to go. Insanity sounds really, really cool, actually. This is going to be our test, I think. Raw beef, I should be able to get that. Mushroom, I should have, and a poppy. Okay, so let me try this. This is going to be a pain in the butt, because it's going to go there. Okay, good. Okay, so I have the poppy. I don't need these other guys. I need a raw beef and a mushroom, right? So if we get those, raw beef and a mushroom. It looks like a red mushroom, so we got to get one of those. All right, no problem. So we put these in. Oh, wait, hold on. Let's take a look at this again, just so I don't mess it up again. Insanity. Okay, so yeah, okay. So we have those, poppy, then mushroom, then raw beef. Does the order matter? Let's test to see real quick if the order actually matters or not. So I'm gonna put in the raw beef and then the mushroom and then that, the thing. So, okay, so that doesn't seem to be working. Does it have to go in the right order? No, that's still not working. Okay, so do I wait? I guess I wait. Let's try it out of order again. We're going to try waiting a minute. No, that's wrong. Give me back. Really? Wait, you know what? Let me just Okay, let's try this again because I messed it up. Raw beef, mushroom, poppy. I'm waiting. Okay, let's try this. I was aiming like in the top of it, I guess. Let's try like at the side. No, see, that's still not working. It's supposed to work. But it's not. Okay, so that didn't work. Let's try it in order. It was this, then the raw beef. And the pestle. I'm on the mortar. But no, it's not working. Do I have the wrong ingredients or something? Hold on, let's check this. Check it again. Petal dust, insanity. Oh, look at you. Okay. I need one more thing. All you guys are probably screaming at me. But the book, the tablet said this. This tablet said Oh my goodness. Okay, I got it. Okay, let's try this now. Now it should work, I think, hopefully. So if we do this and put you away and get the raw beef, so let's try it out of order just to see if it does work this way. And then an old root. Okay, there's an old root in there now. Yeah, I did it. And the order doesn't matter. No macerator required. Who needs pages? Craft a runic tablet. Okay, I didn't even see that one pop up. Use a mortar to craft petal dust. Okay, cool. Cool, man, we got some petal dust now. So the next step is to do what? I need the imbuer. That's what I need. I need the imbuer. Okay, so give me the tablet here. Next page, and you. Okay, so I need to craft this. It has to be chiseled stone bricks, huh? What was it? It was at roots, and it was the imbuer. Where is the imbuer? Crap, really, where are you? Hey, imbuer, show yourself. There you are. See you. Thank you. So I can't do that. It's got to be actual. Whoa. Oh, that's cool. You? Nope, don't have that. Crap. I don't have that either. What are you? Stone brick slab. Okay, I need stone bricks. Okay, you? No. You know what? This is really unfortunate. Just give me some stone because I can do this myself. Stone bricks. Go away. Stone brick slab. Go away. Chiseled. Thank you. See how simple that was? Don't worry about shift clicking sometimes. It doesn't really matter. So do we place this down as well? And then it said to put in a stick. Ooh, look at you. You look pretty neat, man. I like it. Okay, so I need a stick and then the powder, right? Is that what it said? I have plenty of sticks, man. I can do sticks all day long. Can you go here and type? It would really, really mean a lot to me. Okay. I need the stick and the powder, right? Is that it? Is that all? Can you fly faster? Stick, powder. Ooh! Ooh! Oh! Yeah! I have an insanity staff. Look down at the bottom. I have little green leaf things. Okay, so what I want to do, and I'm going to take a cut here because I don't have a whole lot of time left in this episode, but I want to show you what this guy does. 97 uses remaining. That's pretty good, actually. That's not too bad. Because I saw that it had a certain amount of uses, And you can actually increase it. So the base amount of uses is like 97, which is really, really pretty good, actually. It's pretty cool. All right. So, but we're definitely going to play with this. But I got to do something off camera real quick so I can show it to you without wasting too much time. Okay, so it's nighttime. First of all, I want to see the range of this. Oh, crap. You're going to shoot him anyway, aren't you? There's a spider there. All right, let's see if it affects him from this far away. Wait, hold it down. Yeah. Poof. I don't know how big of a range there is. These guys are going to explode. See, now they're really, really close. Are they shooting? Well, he shot each other. But those guys are still on me. I think he just shot him. I don't think that was an actual thing. Kill the skeleton, man. Oh, darn. Ow. I don't have a range weapon, do I? Well, that wasn't exactly what I wanted. You are the chosen one! I got a thing, though. I got an achievement. Cause a monster to betray its friends with the insanity spell. That's going to be really, really cool, actually. This is an interesting little thing. And, like I said, now it has 94 uses. Granted, the first three times I use, or first two times I use it, it wasn't close enough. But as you see, about where I am now, I guess is close enough. You don't have to be like right on top of them, which is really, really good. It doesn't have a super long range or anything, but it's pretty close. And there's some upgrades to the staff later on that we'll get into. But the thing is, there's a lot of different things you can do. You can create an earth spike. You can do a rending strike, which I'm not sure what this does. Create a spell that was shatter target's defenses, multiplying the next damage. Okay, so that increases incoming damage, shatters blocks, so it breaks blocks. Sanctuary, I don't know. There's a lot of these shielding. This, I think, gives range. Okay, nullifies ranged attacks. That's warding. This is sanctuary. Huh. The alluring red tulip. So I guess maybe it was called warding before, but it was renamed to sanctuary. I'm not sure. Or maybe it was renamed to warding, but this in here, you know what I mean? One of them was changed. And in any case, it doesn't really matter. So it boosts, so it nullifies ranged attacks and boosts natural regeneration for those within the circle. That's pretty cool. That's an interesting thing. Shielding repels mobs, stops projectiles, which is pretty cool. While you're holding right click, which is really cool. Blistering cold is, you know, sends them like cold projectiles, like ice shards out or something. Life drain is interesting and self-explanatory. Acceleration, is that for crops? Yeah, tick rate. So furnaces, brewing stands, it increases the tick rate of things. Dandelion winds. So it pushes things, entities. Solar smite is, well, basically a burst of sunlight anywhere. Growth is plant growth. Yeah, growable plants and, yeah, it does a little stuff. Roses, thorns, it hurts mobs, but then it gives them the thorns effect for the next attack. So anything that attacks them will get hurt. Regeneration, that's obviously, you know, it'll heal you via nearby flowers is really cool. Nature's Cure, Water Blast, Electric Spark. So, I mean, there's a bunch of things in here. I don't want to go through all of them in depth or anything. So, I mean, we'll just kind of investigate these as it goes. But yeah, there's a lot of different things. Not only is there the basic spellcraft, but then there's rituals further on, which we're going to get into. And then even further than that, there are sprites. And let me tell you, this thing goes ridiculously in depth. If you haven't seen the Roots mod, go check it out. Just kind of investigate on your own. Read through the tablet. Tablet has plenty of information. It may not be perfect. As you notice, I didn't know how exactly. Like, it wasn't. I don't know. Maybe it was. Maybe you guys got it first try and were like, duh, Zog. It was so easy to understand. Maybe that's true. Maybe I was just being a derp, but it's fine. It kind of tricked me a little bit, but I got it. I figured it out now. So, you know, once you get all of that together, you should be pretty much... Are you shooting me? For real, man? Where'd you even come from? Just die now. Thank you. Sheesh. So, yeah, anyway, so we're going to be getting into the Roots mod. I think that's the next thing we're going to do. And I want to build an area for it, but it's a little hard to figure out exactly how much space we're going to need for things and stuff like that. Forgot to chop that down. I need to do that. And wait, let's go make them go insane. Hold on. Come here, creepers. Come here, everybody down here. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Bing! What did you just do? All right, come here, creepy. You walked right off the edge. Nah. You don't blow each other up? You can blow up. I don't mind. I just don't want to die. Nah. There we go. Ha ha ha. Good. Kind of. Blink. There we go. I don't know. Anyway, so yeah, it's really cool. And now I'm wasting too much time. So we're going to go ahead and cut it. And we'll get into the Roots mod in the next episode. It's going to be really cool. So stay tuned. Check it out. But if you like the episode, don't let that like button get lonely. And subscribe to see more. Check out the Patreon and donation links down below. Thank you for watching. Do what you do. And I will see you next time. Peace out, peeps. Let me go tear this thing down now.